Hi, welcome to Level My Solutions, your authoritative and educative tutorial test series where we engage in down-to-earth discussions as far as mathematical concepts are concerned. And in our previous discussion, we looked at one of the properties of limits of sequence, that is the sandwich property. In this tutorial, I want to just look at an example. See how best you can apply that particular property. So let's look at the example one. And then, so we are evaluating. So evaluate the limit of 5 raised to the power n plus 7. Power n, then all over 100 power n as n approaches infinity. So we are evaluating this. Let's see how best we can do this. So we have this as the main sequence. But by the sandwich property, we should be able to have a sequence which is less than or equal to another sequence. Less than or equal to another one. So that when we know the limit of this one, and it is equal to the limit of this, that's n approaches infinity, then it presupposes that the limit of this particular one is also equal to that one. And that is what we have to do. So let's keep this one and put it here. So we have this particular one. That's what we are proving. So it should be in the middle. We can determine its limits directly. So we put it here. Now we'll surround it with another sequence. So we want a sequence here, which is going to be, so this will be less than or equal to the sequence that we have. Then we want a sequence here, which is going to be less than or equal to what we have here. So we have this one. So we just look at it. We have 5 to the power n, 7 to the power n. So realize that if I start with this, to the power n, obviously this is less than or equal to this. Alright, so this aspect of the condition has been fulfilled. So let's go to the other side. So we have here this, but what we want to write should be greater or equal to what is here already. So if I have 5 here and 7, and I started with 7, and 7 was less than or equal to this. And here I can say, okay, then this should be what, 7 to the power n, n plus 7 to the power n, r raised to the power 1 and 2. So, yes, on the face of it, you realize that this is 5, this is 7, but in this case, we have 7, 7. So this should obviously be greater than or equal to this. In other words, this is what, less than or equal to what we have. So we are gradually fulfilling the condition for the sandwich property. Then, looking at this, we can simplify it a little. From indices, we realize that this will give us 7. And this will be equal to. And here we don't know this, what we are evaluating, so we'll go touch it. We will still retain it. We have this plus 7 to the power that r is the power 1 over n. Less than or equal to. So, all you can do, realize that we have 7 to the power n plus 7 to the power n. 7 to the power n is common. So this is 7 to the power n is common. So we factor 7 to the power n out. So when I factor that one out, you realize that our limit is 1 plus 1. Yeah. Because 1 multiplying this to give me this. 1 multiplying this to give me this. So I haven't made any significant change here. Okay. So let's move on. And then so we come here, we have 7 less than or equal to. So what is in the middle? It's still there. We have 5 to the power n plus 7 to the power n. R is the power that. So it should be less than or equal to. So 1 plus 1 gives us 2. And so we have here 2 multiplying 7 to the power n, then R is the power that. So it implies that we are having 7 less than or equal to 5 power n plus 7 power n. So to us in the power that and less than or equal to. So here we blend in indices as well, you have A multiplying B and they are always to the power N, for instance. Then the results will be given as A to the power N, then multiplied by B to the power N. So with that idea, we can simplify what we have here to become 2 to the power 1 over N, then multiply by, so we have 7 to the power N, then multiply by that. So raise the powers to the power, we multiply their powers, and by so doing, we have here to be what 7. Alright, so other than that, we'll find the limits of all of them. So we have the limits of 7 as N approaches infinity. And it should be less than or equal to the limit of 5 exponent n plus 7 exponent n or raised to the power 1 over n as n approaches infinity. And it should be less than or equal to the limit of, so we have it here, we are taking the limit of both sides, so here it becomes a constant, so you can put it here, limit of 2 exponent 1 over n as n approaches infinity. Alright, so one significant property of limits is that limits of a constant is the same constant. Regardless of there's no variable here for us to do this substitution. So limits of the constant is the same as the constant. So here the value here becomes 7. Less than or equal to, we don't know this aspect, so we still write it as it is. And as n approaches infinity, so this will be less than or equal to. Now, there is a certain limit which says that when you have a limit of a certain function, for instance, like this, as n approaches infinity, we're going to have zero. So, as n approaches infinity, this particular limit exists, we're going to have zero. So we're going to apply that lemma here. Realize that as n approaches infinity, what is here will be approaching 0. So 1 over n here approaches 0. So 2 raised to the power 0, you see how it's going to give us just 1. So we are having 1 here. So 7 multiplied by what 1 will give us 7. We have 7 less than or equal to the limit of 5 plus 10 plus 7. This is n equals to the power 1 over n as n approaches infinity. It will be less than or equal to. So 1 times 7 gives us 7. Right? The limit here is 7. The limit here is also 7. So by the sandwich property of the limit of sequence, so to that by the squeeze property, or the sandwich property, the limit of 5 exponent n plus 7 exponent n as n approaches infinity is equal to 7. So that is that. Alright, so that's all that we have as far as the squeeze theorem is concerned. Thanks very much for watching this tutorial. In our next tutorial, we shall look at another example. Make sure you download that and watch. Thank you very much.